It was the most bizarre thing anybody could have done. The whole country is talking about action against Sushma and Vasundhara. The BJP doesn't do anything on that. It moves against two Congress leaders. That also, after not acting in this case for such a long time. Ajay Bose, no action where it should be. Deflective action on the Congress party appears to me to be the politics of aggressive blackmail.
Arnav, you know, ironically, after the government came to power 1 year ago, we were expecting some firm action on these various corruption scams and scandals involving the UPA.
Yeah.
But we found that the government was moving painfully slowly. Now, suddenly we find that these cases are being pursued with some vigor.
Yeah.
Tell me something, Arnav. This only underlines then the need to investigate scandals of their, in, you know, during their own, you know, in their own party.
Yeah, yeah. Basically, their logic is, Ajay Bose, their logic is, we will not do anything against the Congress leaders, but if you say anything against us, then we'll act against you. So this is the caged parrot philosophy. GVL Narasimha Rao, what kind of a caged parrot have you made the CBI now? What a shame now. You know, you won't act on corruption. You'll defend these two leaders in indefensible situations. And then you will make the CBI into a caged parrot. You called it the Congress Bureau of Investigation. Remember that? What should we call it now?
We have been in office for more than 13 months and Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi is a man with a positive mandate, a positive mission, a futuristic leader, somebody who is not, he's not a Sonia Congress style, he doesn't practice Sonia Congress style vendetta politics. For 10 years, Sonia Gandhi and her government had nothing but to do a witch hunt against Mr. Modi. It was very easy for him after taking office in Delhi.
Sir, you moved
after the Congress party.
Exactly. Why didn't you take action earlier? Why didn't you take action earlier?
We are not taking action.
You should have taken the investigation earlier. No, of course you've taken action. You've taken it. What was the CBI waiting for? CBI was waiting for Sushma Swaraj to be exposed. CBI was waiting for Vasundhara Raje to be exposed. You keep files on people. You build evidence against people.
Investigation.
Where was the investigation till now? The investigation was in cold storage after preliminary inquiry was launched on May 13, 2014 when the UPA was in power. This investigation was in cold storage. You have got a freezer of charges that you pick up whenever you're in trouble. You want to run the government by blackmail. I'd like to get Tom Vadakkan's reaction.
Why are you becoming an apologist?
I'm asking you, don't accuse me of becoming an apologist to anyone. Why don't you act against Sushma and Vasundhara instead?
Why are you becoming an apologist?
Please hold back these compliments. Hold back these compliments. Answer my question. Hold back the compliments.
No, that's the question. The country wants to know.
Well, the country. I'll tell you what the country wants to know.
Congress corruption.
I'll tell you what the country wants to know. The country wants to know.
We have answered.
One second. I'll tell you one thing. 47 news breaks on Vasundhara and Sushma. Have you spoken once? You go into hiding on Vasundhara and Sushma.
Arnav,
you tell me today.
I don't know.
You're in hiding on Vasundhara and Sushma.
The Prime Minister, the entire party has been speaking on this.
Sir, I tell you. GVL Narasimha Rao. GVL Narasimha Rao, one second. I want to say something to you. You have used language that I object to.
Don't get frustrated.
Sir, you have used language that I object to. Sir, you don't have to try and get personal with me.
Tell me today. Why are you questioning me?
Mr. Rao, let me tell you one thing.
Is that corruption?
Mr. Rao.
Are you giving a clean certificate to the Congress party?
No, Mr. Rao.
Are you giving a clean certificate to Wagela?
Mr. Rao,
are you standing up for Wagela and
Mr. Rao, I'd like to remind you this one thing. You are presently on a channel that has broken all the scams of corruption of all political parties in the last 5 years. I don't need a certificate from you.
No, but why are you silent?
Mr. Rao, Mr. Rao, this is not a Neera Radia channel. It's not a Cash for Votes channel. So let me be very specific with you. Have some respect when you speak to someone on Times Now. Now my question is, my question to you is, the CBI launched the preliminary inquiry in the disproportionate assets case against Veerbhadra Singh. And by the way, you should know this. The Veerbhadra Singh story was also broken. One second. The Veerbhadra Singh story was broken on Times Now. Don't you talk to me like that. You are talking about a scam we exposed. I am asking you, which channel? Okay, so let me ask you, which channel broke the Veerbhadra Singh scam? Which channel broke the Veerbhadra Singh scam? Answer my question.
It is the job of the CBI to.
Which channel broke the Veerbhadra Singh scam, sir?
Now you ask a question to your viewer.
The answer is Times Now. So by the way, we broke the story. So please be careful who you are talking to.
Why are you taking?
No. One second. So Mr. I did not. Mr. GVL Narasimhara, if you get personal with me, I'll have to explain a few things to you. My question now is, and don't interrupt me, this case, the CBI launched a preliminary inquiry into the disproportionate assets case against Veerbhadra Singh when the BJP finds itself in the dock on August 27th last year. It had stated to the Delhi High Court that it has not found evidence to register a regular case on the matter. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Please don't.
Do you understand what I'm saying or not?
To me,
I am quoting what, sir. I am quoting the fact, and you are going to be really embarrassed right now. That on the 27th of August, sir, remember this. I'm telling you, you are now coming on a channel which has broken the story. I know more about the Veerbhadra Singh issue than you do or the BJP does. But your CBI, your government gave a clean chit to Veerbhadra Singh on August 27th last year. Now when Sushma and Vasundhara are in trouble, you suddenly remember the case. I question the timing. I'm getting Tom Vadakkan to respond, and then I'll have a bone to pick with you on that.
Tom Vadakkan.
Sir, why do you give a clean chit then? You're coming back to the story now.
On the 17th June morning, 7 o'clock in the morning, 12 men from the CBI, without papers, descend on Mr. Wagela's house. They first raid his residence, they find nothing. Then they follow it up his sons, where they find nothing. The third son, whose house he runs a college, and whose fees was deposited, the fees of the college was deposited, 11 lakhs were found. The search was completed at 5 o'clock, but the CBI remained on the premises till they get orders from the higher ups. Now, this is puppeteering of the CBI. I charge. Arrest me tomorrow or today, when anybody moves out, they will get arrested. We are not worried. We'll go to the streets. We'll go to the people's court. We are not bothered about the CBI. You may arrest me tomorrow or today when I step out. I'm not bothered, Mr. Rao. Nor is the party bothered. Mr. Rao, we are not worried. We are stepping out to the streets. Mr. Rao, we are stepping out to the streets in Delhi. To the across the country. You may arrest our leadership, but we are going to come out to the streets. We'll fill the jails. Mr. Rao, we'll fill the jails. We are not bothered about Modi. You have done vindictive politics. You have done, even you are, Mr. Advani, you are not spared. You are not spared, Mr. Joshi. Mr. Advani, Mr. Joshi. That's all vindictive politics.
I'd like to mention another BJP friend. One second. Just 1 minute, please.
710 crores.
All right. I want Ashish Khaitan to come into the debate and Gaurav Bhatia as well. I have one fact to state before I come to them. You know what happened on New Year's Day 2014? A friend of the BJP, the eminent Ranjit Sinha of Diary Gate fame, the most dubious policeman I have known who has headed the BJP, Ranjit Sinha said, much to the happiness of BJP? The BJP. CBI. One second. You know what CBI Director Ranjit Sinha said? Ashish Khetan. He says on New Year's Day, this Veerbhadra Singh matter is essentially a state matter and I can't get into it unless I'm specifically told to do so by the Himachal Pradesh High Court. In other words, Ashish Khetan, the CBI says in January, we don't want to look into the case. Suddenly, there's a sudden revival in the case, exactly at a time when the BJP is in the dock over Sushma and Vasundhara. QED, matter proven. Matter proven, explain now.
We call the CBI.
Ashish, don't, no, no. People know what you said about misuse of CBI before the election. Sir, please.
Who appointed Ranjit Sinha? Who appointed Ranjit Sinha?
Oh, my God, who appointed? What did you say when Ranjit Sinha? Why did you close the matter earlier and open the matter now? Why was the matter closed earlier and open now? You tell me. You tell me. You tell me. Why was the matter closed earlier and open now? Is there some propriety in this?
And Ranjit Sinha.
Why was it closed earlier and open now? Ashish Khetan.
Who paid, who possibly gave a reprieve to the Congress.
I think, Arnav.
Sir, you tell me what is happening in the BJP nowadays.
Mr. No, Rao, can I come in,
you
please?
You are forgetting
until now when the critics
corruption by Wagela, you are forgetting all the malpractices of.
Sir, how can you say forgetting?
You want to keep your
sir, I'm sorry, I'm telling you once again. You are on a channel. Sir, you are on a. I today have, by the way, I don't need to prove it to you. I have got legal notices from people associated with Veerbhadra Singh when I broke the story.
On,
we take the risk. Don't tell me. You, why did you close the case? Why did you close the case against Veerbhadra Singh? We exposed it. Why did you close the case? Tell the people of this country. Why did you close the case? Why did you close the case? You tell people today. You tell people today, GVL Narasimha Rao, why did you close the case? Why did you close the case earlier and open it now? Why did you close it earlier? Did you do a sweetheart deal with Veerbhadra Singh?
A few questions I wanted to raise.
Did you do a sweetheart deal with Veerbhadra Singh then?
The sweetheart CBI deal? Director at that time.
Okay, can I come in here?
At that time had taken a position. The government does not tell the CBI which case to be pursued, which case.
And then why has it taken a U-turn now?
Not Sonia Congress. This is not Sonia Gandhi Congress.
What are you doing, sir?
BJP. If we want it. If he wanted,
Ashish Khetan is responding now.
All of them in
Ashish Khetan into the debate along with Gaurav Bhatia. Ashish Khetan and Gaurav Bhatia.
What about Dhumal? Dhumal.
Well,
is it a Ashish Khetan?
Mr. Rao, please.
Is it a quid pro quo? What about Dhumal?
Ashish Khetan.
Talk about it, Mr. Rao.
Once again.
Come on, record on this.
Until now, when the critics of the Modi government used to call this government UPA 3, people would take that as hyperbole. But after what has happened today, I think it is no more a hyperbole. It's a state of fact. And I'll tell you why. You remember a case called Mayawati's disproportionate asset case and cash corridor scam?
Yeah.
Three regimes, NDA, UPA 1, UPA 2, kept that case alive, kept that case in the balance to use that as a political tool to blackmail Mayawati and to force her into submission as and when required.
What's your allegation?
You remember a case called the disproportionate assets of Mulayam Singh Yadav?
Yeah.
In 2007, the UPA said Mulayam Singh Yadav and his family was corrupt. In 2009, the UPA 2 went to the Supreme Court and said that Mulayam Singh Yadav and his family was honest. In 2011, they again went back to the Supreme Court and they said no, Mulayam Singh and his family are corrupt. This is, please sir, let me complete. I'm just narrating the facts. This is exactly what you're doing today. You know, when Modi pitched himself as the Prime Minister of India and said, told the people to vote for me and not pick maybe an LK Advani or a Murli Manohar Joshi, but Mr. Narendra Modi as the Prime Minister of India, what did he promise? He said, I will be different from NDA.
After this,
who used to use CBI as a political instrument of blackmail?
We don't need certificates from Aam Aadmi Party.
Of timing criminal investigation with the timing of complete with the exigencies of the political time. Please let me complete. Let me complete, sir. What we are seeing today, a criminal investigation perfectly timed to suit the political needs of a party in power.
Yeah.
This is exactly
what
we
used to see during UPA 1 and UPA 2. Ashish Khetan,
selective application of law is not the rule of law. selective application of law is does not tantamount to the rule of law. It's only equal application of law which leads to the rule of law and institutional integrity and constitutional democracy. And today we don't have a constitutional democracy in this country because we see selective application.
Okay,
of law.
Okay.
There may be merit.
I in think okay, no, 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 no. I'll let a combined response.
Party. Though it's limited to Delhi.
Now can I come
in? If there is any danger to democracy, it is from Aam Aadmi Party in Delhi.
Gaurav Bhatia.
Now I would like to make my point.
Celebrating its democracy.
Gaurav Bhatia is taking on
your
the BJP now.
Father, your patron,
yeah.
Your ideologue and the statesman.
I would
Mr.
like
Mr. L.K. Advani has made it
like
very clear.
Yes.
That if there is a danger to the democracy in this country, it is the combined of
democracy and threatened today. Democracy.
The CBI was a caged parrot in UPA. The CBI is still a caged parrot. And the CBI is now the controlled Bureau of Investigation, controlled by the BJP, to do their vindictive politics and settle political
scores.
As Mr. Ashish Khaitan was
saying, I'd also like to remind the viewers. I'd also like to remind the viewers that the same CBI did not file an appeal.
One second, gentlemen, one second. Let Gaurav come make his point. One at a time, gentlemen. Gaurav is making an important interjection. Let Gaurav complete his point.
Can I make my point?
Please.
Can I make my point?
Please go ahead.
Now, my question to Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao is this. That if there can be a PE for preliminary inquiry by the CBI for Congress leaders, when there is so much of evidence against Vasundhara Raje, when we know a loan was extended to the tune of 12 crores to Mr. Dushyant Singh, why can't they order a preliminary inquiry by the CBI against both of them, who are public servants, who are prima facie at least, done an illegality under the prevention of
Gaurav Bhatia.
But
for they are very busy. Gaurav,
you
are very busy with the Congress. They are extremely busy with the Congress.
No, let Mr. Rao respond, Tom.
Today, the nation wants to hear Mr. Narendra Modi tonight.
Yes, I will
Mr.
answer.
Narendra Modi promised that he will eradicate
this government
from India. And today what we see in the
this
BJP
government
regime is crony capitalism, corruption and nepotism.
This government believes in the rule of law. This government
rule of
believes
law.
In fair play. There is an ED inquiry in all the cases.
And
it's not like Netaji. It's not like Netaji.
Fair play.
Who was blackmailed. Who was blackmailed in Paris every month.
Step before
Netaji was scared.
And when the material that has surfaced on the media,
Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav was blackmailed for 10 years by the Congress party. I think you have you accepted it on record.
Why can't a preliminary inquiry?
Gaurav Bhatia, your leader was arm twisted by Sonia Gandhi and Congress party for 10 years. You were forced to support Congress party for 10 years. Your Netaji was scared to go to jail. And he compromised and you
today,
surrendered to
I
Sonia Gandhi and Congress
BJP
party.
The BJP needs to do the answering.
You
have no
right
to deflect from the main topic. The entire nation
not,
today
the real topic is
voting
CBI
for the BJP.
And your Neta
fooled them
was
on
the icon
you
of
fooled
submission.
Them on employment and now even on corruption.
Your
Let
Neta
me say
was
this on record. The
Neta
BJP
ji.
Is proving to be faster and more corrupt. Than the UPA too.
Okay, 1 second, please. 1 minute.
I
one minute.
I am saying, yeah,
1 minute.
Talk about
Mr. Rao. Mr. Rao. I must say. I must say, Mr. Rao. I want to compliment Mr. Rao. I want to compliment Mr. Rao. May I compliment him? I compliment you, Mr. Rao, for your bold, unfettered, uninhibited, and courageous utterance on the news hour tonight. That you believe in the.
I'm on the side of.
That, that
right
you believe.
Side.
Allow me to complete.
So
when I pass a compliment which
right.
is rare, and you know I don't compliment politicians very often, please accept it, sir. I compliment you for the courage you have shown in committing yourself and your party and your government
to the
rule of law.
Speak,
no. He talks about the rule of law. I compliment him. So where is the rule of law when that enforcement directed inquiry was put into deep freeze? Now, where is the rule of law when the court order against the restoration of Lalit Modi's case was not moved? The file did not move, sir. Where is the rule of law, sir? When Dushyant Singh is being investigated right now,
where is the rule of law?
Dushyant Singh is being investigated for crores of rupees made by Lalit Modi. Why don't you have a rule of law? As I have a rule of law and an institute, have a rule of law and apply the same rules that you applied to others and institute forthwith an SIT against Sushma Swaraj and Vasundhara Rajay. Have courage to apply yourself to a rule of law. Don't preach about a rule of law if a rule of law is only a theoretical construct in your mind. Sir, remember this.
No,
I remember what you said earlier.
It is what this
government
practices.
It's a theoretical construct in your mind.
For 4 years, law changes.
Sir, please.
When they are in the opposition.
You want to tell me about the rule of law?
Incompetent.
The rule of law is different.
For 4 years, incompetent.
This is rule of law.
Could do nothing.
Sir, you match.
For 4 years,
sir, did you say to the people of India?
And an incompetent Mr. Chidambaram. Could do nothing.
And did you say to the people
of
India?
They wanted to bring him back.
No, no. Did you?
Why did they pay?
Did you say?
He has been in office for 12 months. The cases are very much on.
He promised that he will give a corruption-free government. He didn't say that he will replicate the UPA 2 model.
This is a totally corruption-free government.
Who need
the only corruption-free government?
This is a corruption-free government.
Independent.
After Lalit Gate, this is a corruption-free government.
In the corruption of
After Lalit Gate, this is a corruption-free government. One second. I think Ashish Khetan is coming in on that. Ajay Bose also wants to come in.
Absolutely.
Corruption-free government. Okay. A corruption-free government.
Absolutely.
So a corruption-free government in which the foreign minister does dubious deals with a person who runs away with thousands of crores from this country. A corruption-free government where a chief minister, where a chief minister cheats the people of this country, where her son makes money and her daughter-in-law makes money. A corruption-free government where the BJP refuses to act against these individuals. Sir, remember this. What you say will come and bite you. Did you say to the people of India, Mr. Rao, tell me tonight, did you say to the people of India that if Manmohan Singh was...
We will lose power, but we will not lose our sanity. We will not let any corruption happen.
Really?
I'm giving this statement on your program.
I don't believe in you. Then what was Sushma Swaraj doing? Why is Swaraj Kaushal interceding on Lalit Modi's behalf? Why is Swaraj Kaushal accepting hotel rooms booked for him by Lalit Modi? Why is Mazuri Kaushal a lawyer for Lalit Modi and Sushma Swaraj using her discretionary powers for him?
All these questions have been answered.
Don't give lectures if you can't do anything about it.
Nothing of this happened after our government came to office.
Really?
In 2011. If somebody, he was IPL chairman.
What are you talking about?
It's for them to answer.
Sir,
this government, sir, has been in office for 13 months.
Sir, Sushma Swaraj, Sushma Swaraj did what she did as Foreign Minister of India. Anyway, you become brazen. Ashish Khetan. Ashish Khetan.
Can I please complete? A corruption-free government is one which doesn't continue with the corrupt CBI director appointed by the previous regime. A corruption-free government is one which doesn't have a YS Yedurappa as a party vice president who is involved in an iron...
There is no provision to remove CBI director.
Please let me complete, sir. Please.
Do you know the law?
Let me, sir.
Do you know the law?
Let me come.
It shouldn't be...
Sir, you can't have reached the law
before
I have completed.
I think don't give
the law and law to the people of
law
this country.
Law does not permit government to remove CBI director.
A corruption-free government is one. Acha, what is the compulsion in having YS Yedurappa as a party vice president involved in an iron ore scam of 70,000 crore rupees?
Well,
what is the compulsion in having Gadkari as a transport minister
is
involved
and named
in a scam by the CAG itself?
Look at members in your own party.
Where is your zero tolerance towards corruption?
I think you have lost.
Where your zero tolerance
whatever
towards corruption?
Little morality was
a corruption-free government is one which would not have 31 ministers. 31% of your ministers in your cabinet are involved in heinous crimes.
No Wait, corruption allegation.
Riot.
Tell me who is facing allegations.
This is a corruption allegation.
This is the track record of your ministers.
Sushma Swaraj.
You call yourself
tell
a corruption
me one minister facing charges.
You have
of
Nitin Gadkari in your rank.
Sushma Swaraj.
You call yourself.
One second. You ask a question.
You
take it. No, one second.
I think your Kejriwal.
Corruption free.
Your Kejriwal.
You have Vasundhara Raje. You have Dushyant Singh.
Wants to have an out of court.
You have Sushma Swaraj.
I think you are making these statements.
The only thing that you have not done is
which court of law
appointing Lalit Modi as your cabinet minister.
Court of law is he facing charges? None of the ministers is facing any charge of corruption in any court of law. I challenge you to disprove this. I am giving you a challenge on this program.
Okay, now
which minister
there,
in
there
this
will never be a court of law,
a corruption case
of law until you file cases.
This will
tell
be a
me what action
court?
Have you taken in a preliminary inquiry registered with CBI against Mr. Gautam Adani?
No, Kejriwal will hold up.
Tell me on national television today. Don't
in
you have a preliminary
case?
Inquiry against Gautam Adani, the closest confidant of Mr. Narendra Modi? Tell me, isn't the CBI sitting on
you,
a preliminary inquiry against Gautam Adani?
Anyone
say
facing
it.
A charge
say, deny
will
it.
Face the consequences.
Deny it on the national television.
This government
that you don't
does
have
not
a preliminary
protect
inquiry
anybody.
Against Gautam Adani.
Okay, now I'm asking a very important question. 1 minute, please. No, one second. I promise tonight, Mr. Rao, more exposés on this story. And in that context, I want to ask you a question on record tonight. No, Ashish. Ashish, I ask tonight and read my lips.
Arnab, can I ask?
No, Gaurav, 1 second. Let's get the BJP spokesperson on record tonight. Because he knows we are following the story. I'm asking a question. Let this tape be played. If tomorrow I can prove that a direct relative of a union minister, read my lips, participated in a commercial arrangement with a person facing serious charges of corruption, will you, and if I prove it, a commercial transaction and a corporate transaction, remember, read my lips, a commercial and a corporate transaction between a direct relative of a sitting union minister and the union minister's spouse and the company which is being accused of corruption, will you sack the minister forthwith?
Please
don't mumble, answer me.
No, I'm answering.
Don't mumble.
I'm answering.
Answer.
I'm giving a direct answer.
No, he must answer. No, Ajay Bose, he must answer.
Yeah, no minister, I can say this for the Prime Minister, he would not let any minister with charges of corruption.
No, don't give charges, don't define corruption.
Or
don't define corruption to me.
No, you have to.
5 days.
Come on.
Give me a straight
answer.
Should he give a straight answer?
Be,
not giving me a straight
answer. Corruption has to be specified.
What corruption
no
has to be specified? Okay, fine.
Will
fine.
Say,
okay,
will
okay.
Survive in this government.
Okay, now let
no
me ask.
No corrupt minister will survive in this government.
Okay,
very simple. Straightforward. Specify.
No, he's not answering the question. Look, you are looking so nervous tonight. You see,
no corrupt minister will survive in this government.
I need
your categorical answer.
Then tell me, no, one second. One minute, please. 15 to Lalit K.
Samajwadi Party government.
Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao. Mr. GVL Narasimha Rao. Mr. Rao, take the questions. People want to hear you take my questions tonight. 5 day into Lalit Gate. I have not heard a single alphabet or a word from your Union Finance Ministry on whether Sushma Swaraj told them about Lalit Modi's request coming her way to do nothing. You would mean you are giving a free pass to a person who has subverted an ongoing investigating agency, Enforcement Directorate probe, and taken the side of an accused who is an evader of Indian law. And you tell me tonight there is no corruption if there is one person accused of corruption tonight. It is Sushma Swaraj. Don't you understand? And I don't care tonight whether she has RSS or Murli Manohar Joshi or Advani camp support. Who cares about your internal politics? We care about action, Mr. Rao. We care about action, Mr. Rao. We want to extract action
there
from
no
your own promise.
Corruption. I think you are you create something.
Mr. Rao,
you believe in your own campaign.
Mr. Rao,
where are the charges of corruption?
Mr. Rao, a government of India cannot approve. Government of India cannot approve of the practice of those in power seeking personal favors from those under formal scrutiny of investigating agencies. Sir, please understand, you cannot do this. People are going to lose faith. You cannot do this to the people of India, sir.
The moral
sir, you
compass
can't
of
do
this,
this
government if
I just don't understand.
Any other government this country has
who
seen.
Cares about any
I
other government? Ask about your government, sir. People voted for you. question coming your way.
Yes, we are completely honest governance. There
sir, that's
no
not an issue I'm asking.
Of any corruption. That's the bottom line.
You keep repeating that, sir. Even Kalmadi said that.
No, because that's the reality.
So that's the reality. When Manmohan Singh said that, you didn't listen to him. Gaurabhatia.
I'd like to make a point.
Gaurabhatia.
You have not made one charge.
Sir, I'll tell you one thing. Prove it.
A preliminary inquiry is.
Prove it that you are against corruption. Don't give me lectures about it.
Somewhere. The BJP
I think people know this. The people of the country have faith in us.
The country wants action, sir. The country doesn't want your words.
Where is the Prime Minister? Why can't he speak on the subject and reassure the people of the country that he will act and he will not tolerate corruption in the ministry?
Exactly. I think where do you disappear?
Why is he quiet?
Where do you disappear? Third. When journalists Third. Are burnt to death in your state,
for that
your minister, your chief,
explain.
You don't
Why
sack a minister where journalists
Mr.
are burnt to death.
Take a loan of
and your leader is blackmailed by
Lalit
the Sonia Congress. You have nothing, you have no shame to accept it. I think you want to ask questions to our Prime Minister.
So these
you have no moral authority to ask questions.
Transactions where you help an offender and you get
Gaurabhatia, you have no moral standing whatsoever.
Charges. Get them investigated from the CBI and let the truth come out. You will be surprised to say how corrupt your Chief Minister of Rajasthan is.
So, you know, to take no action against Sushma Swaraj also
Mr.
means...
Mr. Bhatia has raised an important point.
No. Ajay Bose.
Mr. Rao just a few minutes before said how incompetent the previous government was in bringing back
For
Lalit
four years,
Modi.
They could do nothing.
That may well be. What did your government do? Actually, instead of being incompetent, you secretly called up and tried to help him. Forget about incompetent. You secretly, without informing
Nobody
anybody,
called him. Get your
without
facts
informing
right.
any finance
Get your
ministry,
facts right.
without informing
Get
any
your
official.
Facts right.
So please,
nobody called him
please,
to give favors
please.
To him. It was he.
No, you called to help
for
him.
You called
to help him without informing anybody. And you say,
I want you to understand this. Please understand, nobody is questioning why you are acting against Veerbhadra and Vaghela. Please do, with our compliments.
Please do.
There is no problem. Please do go ahead and act against them. But that's not the issue. And
Can
in
I
fact,
make a
you,
point?
But if you want to selectively use your agencies only against a few leaders, then people will ask you your question. The fact is, accusations against Veerbhadra and Vaghela are serious. They have been under CBI inquiry for a while. You can't follow this process. So what is your fight against corruption about? You have some deep freeze out there. You believe in this kind of politics, then this is not a fight against corruption. You are using corruption charges for blackmail. If you wanted to act against these two, you should have acted by now. Why are you waiting for a time to shoot your arrow? No, when you find that people are asking questions on Sushma. Anyway, to take no action against Sushma Swaraj means the government of India approves of a union minister's husband taking personal favors from an enforcement directorate accused. Asking an enforcement directorate accused and in the past having commercial deals with a person. To take no action against Sushma Swaraj means the government of India endorses the move of the union minister not mandating Lalit Modi to go through the Indian High Commission in London to get his travel documents so that the evader of law will not only get a travel document till such time is needed instead of getting one that is valid for 2 years. You are basically allowing Lalit Modi to negotiate terms. You realize how serious this is or has the... seriousness of the matter not hit you? Every Indian today has understood the seriousness of the charges against Sushma Swaraj. And do we care whether she has the Advani camp support or the Amit Shah camp support? That's your internal problem. Do we care about it, Ajay Bose? Which camp of the BJP is backing whom?
They can play their political games. My point of the whole thing is looking so much murky. We would welcome them to take much firmer action. all these cases about the previous Congress regime, we would welcome it. The country would cheer. But that means it makes it all the more imperative to act against your own when they are found doing something improper and this thing, you know, then what credibility will you have?
What credibility remains?
Ajay,
no.
Prime
and
Minister,
by
the whole please country
take action.
Knows. How come you don't know?
Please take
the
action against
knows.
Various
this
people.
This Prime Minister has enforced the code of conduct. This Prime
code
Minister
of conduct?
Has enforced
absolute.
The code of ethics.
Code of conduct?
Absolute
yes.
nonsense.
To the entire cabinet.
Have you heard a thing
to
like that?
To the entire administration. Nobody
heard
can
a thing
bring
like that?
This.
So under
I think the people of the country know this. I think
code
without
of,
without,
God,
without getting
conduct,
your facts right, you want to
land.
Indulge in mudslinging. This is not going to make
That's
impact.
What
but this Prime Minister has enforced code of
facts.
Conduct, code of ethics,
these are all
and
facts.
Have you not? The whole nation knows. How come you don't know?
I mean, you want to live in some kind of fantasy land, then you can. But I'm telling you,
tell me
you're
what,
losing
what
credibility
can?
By
I
the minute,
months,
by the hour.
13 months,
5 days have passed,
of,
and you have not taken any action.
Allegation against this government. Why are we
what are these? What are these Lalit Gate?
Minister
5 days. What,
the,
what is Lalit Gate?
There is no scope for anyone. There is no scope for anyone to breach that. That's the bottom line. That's the Lakshman Rekha. Anyone who breaks it will certainly face
okay,
the
okay, then tell me. Then tell me. Is, then tell me, GVL Narasimha Rao. I have a question for you.
Which
you
is the, what is the border line?
No, no. What?
Where
no.
is the Lakshman Rekha?
Arnab, let me ask you.
Where is the Lakshman Rekha?
It's widely known.
Is this case
Arnab,
below the Lakshman Rekha?
Go back
or
and,
has this case
go back and read papers.
Which is
go back and read newspapers.
No, I want to ask.
What kind of guidelines were issued to the administration?
By which code of conduct?
What they were told
by
to
which
practice.
Code of conduct do you allow
go and read
your
it.
Union minister to side with an offender and not with the law enforcement agency?
And not
which
tell
code
anybody
of
else.
That allows a cabinet minister to give inordinate concessions, favors, and take favors in return in the name of a family to an offender from the law and keep it away from the law enforcement agencies. Is this
Arnab,
your code of conduct?
To ask a question.
Which code of conduct
that
allows you
that has
to
been
have
explained,
11 crore rupees
that has been explained
in the name
by
of
several
the
ministers
of
in the government?
Minister.
That has been explained by several leaders,
company.
Several leaders
a
in the party.
Company.
I don't
it
want to.
Exist.
I don't want to
it
waste your viewer
business.
Time
get
in repeating it.
11 crores
the,
through
this,
wrong tipping
this was made
from
clear
Mauritius.
Several days ago.
I think
it's not
you
like your party, Ashish Khetan. We don't say something
it's
and we don't practice something
conduct.
Else. We are what we are.
Okay,
we don't
on
make
code of
a pretense like you
oh,
do.
Really?
Like Arvind Kejriwal does.
This means you are a
we
party
don't make
of
a pretense
Dushyant
like you.
It means you are a party of Lalit Modi's. It means you are a party of Vasundhara Raj's. It means your party of
I think the people of the country can draw their conclusion. You are a party of Santosh Bharti. You are a party of Dipen Chintoma. Your leader, your leader believes in ideals of Jitendra Singh. You are a fake party. You are a fake party. Kejriwal is fake. That's what you, if you tell me this, I will tell you the same thing. Arvind Kejriwal is fake like Jitendra Singh Tomar. Your entire party stands on completely. You are a party of poetry.
If you hold back,
so
if you hold back,
I can give, I can pay you in the same coin, Ashish Khetan.
I'll just say one thing.
Pay you back in the same coin.
Okay, who has involved in corruption in a party? Have you given inordinate concessions, illegal concessions, out of turn favors to offenders from law?
I think you are completely
have
your party
Lalit
is
Modi?
Exposed.
Have
so don't give lectures.
Scam?
Don't preach
were
morality.
We caught taking cash on camera?
I think you don't.
Were we talk,
your party
were we caught
has
in,
no moralistic
were we
standing today,
like
no moral
Lalit,
standing
Lalit
whatsoever.
Have you been named in CAG reports like Nitin Gadkari has been named? Do we have a YSA to
I think your leader was completely exposed.
Crore rupees. I know.
I think you are a party.
Do we have
a party
Lalit
of
Modi in a
fake
party?
Leaders?
Do we have a Dushyant
you are
Singh
a party who indulge in violence against women.
Like Lalit Modi?
I think
you
your party has touched the lowest
like
level
Modi.
That any party
with hawala operators.
I think
with hawala operators, with money launderers. You are having
you
a nexus, a deep-rooted nexus
have,
with money launderers, hawala operators, scamsters,
hawala route.
Right accused, rape
so
accused,
far,
you name
so
it and you have it.
Not been able to explain.
What
you've
are you
not
talking?
Been able to explain how you got hawala money into your corporate account, your party accounts.
You've still not answered.
Hang us.
The country.
Hang us. You said your prime minister said
to us.
Your prime minister said that they are going to hang us.
You
we are waiting to be hanged. When are you going to hang us?
What you
for
see.
Taking that 2 crore rupees of donation in the name of the party? When are you going to hang
and
us,
the
sir?
The whole country has seen.
We are waiting. You have the law enforcement agencies, income tax, ED, CBI, Delhi police. When will you hang us?
Where are your donors? They have not been seen so far.
This
fake
shows
donors,
how
fake party
this
leaders,
shows how brazen you have become.
Everything is
how
fake
brazen
about your party.
You have become. How morally corrupt you have become.
And you
I don't. I don't expect
us.
A prime minister to vouch for the integrity or virtuousness of every
lessons.
Minister in his cabinet.
People
but
know.
I do expect a prime
People
minister that once incontrovertible evidence
to.
Is put before him, he would take action. He would take action. A leader is one when confronted with incontrovertible
what
evidence takes action.
He did not
a leader is one who doesn't deflect.
Are you
a leader is one who doesn't hide. A leader is one who doesn't indulge in witch hunt.
Okay,
a leader is one who applies law equally.
A question is this. Please, gentlemen,
he,
one
can
second.
You say that today you are
gentlemen, I hate to break this up between both
he's
of you.
Asked,
okay, one second. There are some others. One second. Mr. Rao and Ashish Khetan. Now, I'm on a fundamental issue of propriety. Mr. Rao, I'm on a fundamental issue of propriety. I'm repeating tonight, please go and take action against Veerbhadra Singh and Vaghela. Veerbhadra Singh accused of acquiring disproportionate assets, conflict of interest, quid pro quo, monetary angle to these cases makes them very serious. We expose the story. We know these are interesting issues. The fact of the matter is that when allegations of quid pro quo against Veerbhadra Singh surfaced in December 2013 and January 2014, the Congress was evasive, did nothing to remove him as Chief Minister of Himachal Pradesh. And if the BJP is brazening it out in the case of Sushma Swaraj and Rajay, then please hold your horses. You brazened it out in the case of Veerbhadra Singh because you thought he's the only way to win an election. So don't lecture from the pulpit the Congress party. That's all I'll tell you. Now come back to this issue. My question, and I think I'd like Gaurav Bhatia. Gaurav Bhatia and Mr. Rao can come in. The question is this. To the viewers tonight, when a minister, that also a foreign minister of India, takes highly sensitive decisions in secrecy, unilaterally, and without the consent of anyone in her ministry and in the government, at a time when the use of her discretionary powers benefits directly or indirectly her husband and her daughter, I think all rules have been broken. That's
all
why.
Rules of conduct are gone.
No, that's and after this, if the Prime Minister and Amit Shah say, if the Prime Minister and Amit Shah say, listen, we got 282, we'll do what we want. If your entire approach is going to be, we'll do what we want. Let the media not go. Doesn't matter. We have got our... Sir, remember, there is a constitution in this country. And that constitution applies to people. Tomorrow you get 500 seats, that constitution will apply to you.
No. That means that half can do anything to 67 out of 70.
I want to tell Mr. Narasimha Rao a few things. Now, Mr. Narasimha Rao, please understand that... The Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, promised that this would be a corruption-free nation. I want to ask you, why don't you free the CBI from your political clutches and let it operate independently? Why don't
Absolutely.
You appoint a Lokpal?
Gaurav Bhatia,
the
Gaurav Bhatia, can I
the
answer
CBI?
That?
You will never do that because you know
no,
that
no,
your
no,
own leaders
that?
Are well entrenched in
that.
Corruption. And that is why... All
it's
institutions
a good question.
Like the
it's
CBC,
a good question. I'll answer
like
that.
The CIC, like the Lokpal, are being destroyed by the BJP. And
Gaurav,
it is also a known fact that the BJP
not been,
is not being able
CBI,
to hold on
please,
to the intense
the
scrutiny of the media on these issues. And that is why neither
if
the BJP president nor the
that.
Prime Minister is coming forward to reassure the people. And therefore, please don't make
the
any
Prime
false
Minister,
promises now. It is time for you to deliver. If you can't deliver, make space for better governments to come.
It's because the CBI is independent. It is because this government does not misuse the CBI. Your
CBI
Neta,
is independent.
Malayam Singh Yadav ji,
you took
is not
all
being
right.
blackmailed
for 1 year.
your neta was blackmailed
when
in the legislation.
You saw that
the
there
UPA.
Is too much heat
we
on the BJP.
Sir,
not
use blackmail politics.
Come on,
I would have forced you to support
us. Lying on national television.
Who's lying? Who's lying?
Mr. Rao is lying on national television. Misusing CBI. I want to ask him a question now. I want to ask him a question.
Which misused CBI.
Has he? The code of conduct. The code of conduct. Clause 1A. Clause 2, 3.2,
forced to sign
the
ethics
committee. First of all, you're not listening to each other.
We have not done that.
No, I'm coming in. You're not listening to each other.
I charge him.
No, no, Tom, stop. Tom, stop. Tom Vadakkan, stop. Tom, stop. Tom Vadakkan, stop. Tom Vadakkan, stop, please. No, no, everyone stop. Everyone stop. I will allow a last question.
Your Netaji is breathing free.
Okay, 1 second, gentlemen.
Your Netaji is breathing free because it's CBI.
Mr. Rao.
It's independent CBI.
Mr. Rao.
We don't intervene. We don't use it for our political purposes. Because of that, Netaji is breathing
fresh air. Mr. Rao, a question coming your way from Tom Vadakkan. I'll let him ask the question. I'll give you full freedom to respond before I close. Now, because otherwise you won't listen to each other. Now, I give you time, sir, 30 seconds. Make it a quick question. If it's a question, it's a question. It can't become a speech, Mr. Vadakkan. Please, if you are getting into the speech mode, you'll have to wait for the next Rahul Gandhi rally. This is the news hour. Please continue. Ask your question.
Arnab, thank you. The first question is, the foreign minister of this country is charged under the code of conduct, clause 1A, clause 2, 3.2, code of conduct for ministers. The ethics committee has not been informed of her interest, her husband's interest, her daughter's interest. Why? And is the prime minister in consent? Why is he into a political vipassana? Why isn't he speaking? He has this monkey bath. He can talk about the earthquake in Nepal before the Prime Minister of Nepal knows it. You need to answer. I charge you of lying on national television. You have misused the CBI. You have raised cases. My reporters, 15 people had to be arrested from the Congress party. A cover-up operation, a huge operation. 7 o'clock in the morning, you descend on a house and you get nothing. And you lie on national television saying that CBI is not being misused. Mr. Rao, you need to answer
Mr.
to the nation.
Mr. Vadakkan, if you have finished, it was Sonia Gandhi-led Congress which unleashed a witch hunt against Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi when he was Chief Minister for 10 years.
He was very innocent.
You have used every tool. You have used every tool to harass him.
You
have done that to Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav. You have done that to Mayawati.
You have done that to Jagan.
You have done that to every leader who was inconvenient to you.
The communal fury that was created.
I think
what did Vajpayee say?
If he wanted to harass you, 13 months.
What did Vajpayee say?
Months.
What did Vajpayee say about
your,
Modi? What is Advani saying about Modi?
Gentlemen, catching up with you.
Mr. Rao, you have lost the right.
It's the past corruption
that
is haunting you.
To take no action against Sushma Swaraj.
I think this government has absolutely no role. It has no involvement with the CBI.
Time up.
I'll say one sentence at the end. While I appreciate the defense Mr. Rao has put up tonight, I would only say this, Mr. Rao, to take no action against Sushma Swaraj is very serious. It will mean that the government of India is a clique that will stand up for the indefensible when it comes to their own, even when the defense of their own has been crumbled and demolished by facts that have been released truthfully by independent media in the national domain, in the public domain. The choice of action is yours. Our expose will continue. I thank you very much for joining me so far on debate number one, gentlemen, on the News Hour tonight. Thank you.